Hi student, today we will discuss about the division. Last year we have already learned that division, but in this video or this year we will discuss about the properties of division. So first property is that if a number is divided by itself, then the result is always 1. We will take example. Suppose 794 is the number given here, and this 794 divided by 794 means the number divided by itself, the result will be a 1. 794 and 794, the division will be 1. So 794 1 the 794, the result will be 1 because of the subtraction of this will be a 0. So this first property is that if a number is divided by itself, the result is always 1. This 794 divided by 794 means the number divided by itself, the result will be a 1. The result will be a 1. Second property is that if the number is divided by 1, the result will be a number itself. Exact opposite. Means a number divided by 1, the result will be a number itself. Suppose 948, this is the given number, and this 948 divided by 1, so 1 9 are 9, 0, then 4 will come here, 1 4 are 4, again 0, this 8 will come here, 1 8 are 8, so result will be 0. So a number divided by 1, the result will be a number itself. If a number is divided by 1, this 948 divided by 1, the result will be a number itself. The result will be a number itself. Means the result will be a number itself. This is the second property of division. And third property and last property is that if a 0 is divided by non-zero number, the result will be always 0. Suppose this 0 is divided by non-zero, means any number. Suppose 48. This 0 divided by non-zero, this 48 is non-zero number. So this 0 is divided by non-zero number, the result will be a 0. Means 4 0 0 0, then we can say that 8 0 also 0. We can write here 0 0 0 any number. Okay. So if a 0 divided by non-zero number, the result will be a 0. So this is the third property of division. We will take revision it. If a number is divided by itself, the result will be always 1. Second is, the number is divided by 1, then the result is itself. And if a 0 is divided by non-zero, this 0 is divided by non-zero, this 0 is divided by non-zero, the result will be a 0 always. This is the property of division. On the basis of the division, we can solve the problems which is related to this division. Today we have learned the division and the properties. I hope that you have understood better. From tomorrow, we will solve the exercise of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So till then, thank you.